And so students, what are we going to discuss today? Please keep your notebooks ready. Keep your notebooks ready. I know you all have at home also the students. They are the ones that we are really worried about. Are they really studying or not? Okay. Are they busy doing whatever work you told me a few minutes ago, doing that? Right. So please let me see you with your notebooks. What am I going to discuss today is grammar of subject verb agreement. I will be doing with you all tomorrow. And I am going to discuss with you today writing skills. All of you, please take out your now here for you all. Main emphasis this time it is letter writing. Okay, right? So what kind of letters we have? A letter to the editor, we have a letter of complaint, isn't it? Right? So we are going to discuss little things that can be asked in the test. So as you all know, yes, your revision starts, tests start from today. Okay, Monday's English testing. And you will be getting questions from reading skills, comprehension. I have shared an example with you all. Did you go through the passage? Did you solve it? Did you read it? Please read it. Okay. Arvind? Yeah, Vansh? Okay. So please read it and let me know. And yeah, so you'll be getting a reading passage. You'll be questions from writing and grammar. So grammar, of course, we have gap filling and all ways it can be asked. Okay, so narration also, I can give a sentence and I'll say, is it, what are the correct options? Right, so you have to identify that also. You have gap filling, right? You have a subject verb agreement. Subject verb agreement, I can give you as individual sentences. So that's why I'll discuss that in detail tomorrow, okay? With a few examples also, so we get the proper idea, right? Then you have your literature. Literature, you can get extracts, 2-3 extracts. It could be extract-based questions. I've asked stanza from a poem, asking questions about that. Few lines from the chapter, read it and answer the questions which are given, right? And you can get questions overall from any of the chapters. Just asking you direct questions here, not necessary with the extract, okay? So please make sure these are the kind of questions that you are going to be asked. Now we come to the big question is, what kind of questions are we going to get from writing skills? So once we discuss the format, you will be able to answer all kind of questions. Okay, now let's write down the format. Okay, so you have a business letter. You have a letter of complaint. Let us start with the format. Okay, now see, listen to what I am saying. I am saying it is the format. So we have the sender's address. Yes, I write the date. I write the receiver's address. Yes, then I write my subject. Yes, I write my salutation. I write my content. How do I end my letter? I write the close or the complimentary close. Now, let us discuss a few things here. All of you, please look at the blackboard carefully and write down in your notebooks as I tell you. Now, when I ask you, when we do our subjective answers, right? So we are there, I give you a question and you write the letter. Because, you know, okay, this is how I'm going to write the letter. But now let us discuss these little things in detail. Okay, so when I write a letter, this is what the format of the letter should be. This is how it should be written here. But if I ask you questions here, then what are the things that are included in the format of a letter? All these are there. Now, please, all of you, note down here, till here. Your address and date. It is one part. It is called as the heading. Okay, that's one part. Then comes your subject, salutation, then comes your content, then comes your close. Okay, now a subject. When I write the subject, what is it that I have to remember about the subject? Subject has to be detailed. No, subject has to be brief. Subject has to be relevant to the content, right? And it should not be 2-3 sentences long. I look at the subject, I'm able to identify that it has to be, what is the letter about? So what is there about the subject? It is brief. It is relevant, right? Okay. And here, yes. So when I am writing a letter of complaint, I can give my reference also here. I can give my reference letter number here also. Can I? Yes. So it's entirely up to me. I can give it over here and I can write it in the content also. Because generally what I am written over here, I'm going to expand it in the content. Yes. Okay. Coming next is our salutation. So salutation, right? So what is here? If I write down, okay. What if I ask you, I say, Mr. Arora, right? Dear Mr. Which is wrong? Which one is wrong? Mr. Arora, search, isn't it? Do I write a salutation like this? I don't write a salutation like this. I can write, dear sir. I can write, dear Mr. Arora, right? Okay, but I don't mix them together, okay? So what is this here? The correct way of writing the salutation. There's a correct way of writing the date also. So when we are writing it here, I will not put it in numerals. I will put it in the correct form of the date, month, year, right? Okay. And here, when I write, now let us just do these things simultaneously. Are you listening at home? Students at home, are you listening or not? Yes, give me a yes or no. Yes, okay, right. So when I am writing this letter, so when I write a letter of a complaint, I have to complain about my refrigerator or something like that. Who is the audience of that letter? Who is going to read that? When I say audience, audience can be for a letter also, right? So audience of a formal letter, audience of a letter of complaint, who is it? The receiver, the person I'm writing to, the manager I'm writing, the distributor I'm writing to, he is there. When I write a letter to the editor, who is my audience there? Who is the audience? Those who read the letter. Very good. And who are those people who read the letter? The people who read the newspaper, right? And if I say, who has a more audience, or which letter has a more audience? Is it a letter to the editor or a letter of complaint? Letter to the editor. Okay, right? So if I say, who will have a more audience, a letter of complaint or a speech in the morning assembly? Absolutely. Who's going to be the more number of people affected by it? Who are going to be, you know, listening to it? Okay. So when I say audience, who is it? The reader, the listener. Okay. Right. Now here, yes. So please remember this. Okay. So fine. I've discussed about the subject. I've discussed about the salutation. Let's come to the content part. Okay, right? You must remember this is the sequence of the letter. I can have a question there, that what is the correct sequence, right? I could say heading, content, salutation, close, right? Is it right? No, because there's something here in between which is missing, right? So you have to remember, it is your heading, it is your subject, salutation, your content, and your close. Now, what about the content? Have I told you, when you write a letter to the editor, I want 3 paragraphs. When you write a speech, I want 8 paragraphs. When you write an article, I want 7 paragraphs. Is this a fixed thing that I've asked you? No, I have not asked you. So what is it about paragraphs? You are at liberty to write as many paragraphs as long as they are relevant, as long as they are meaningful. And of course, as long as they are connected with what you are saying. So you start a speech. You have to talk about water conservation, and you start about complaining about the municipal corporation not giving enough water. Is it relevant? No. Right? So if I am writing this letter of complaint, I am writing my content. What would be in my first paragraph here? What would be my first paragraph? Yes, come and tell me. What would be in my first paragraph, the letter to complaint? I talk about myself. I talk about why I'm writing the letter. It's not I'm a habitual complainer. Okay, who do I complain today? Today I complain to the editor. Today I complain to the manager. Tomorrow I complain to the transport officer. No, I have a reason to write this. You give your introduction and your purpose. Yes. So of course, you will always talk about your reference letter if there has been here. Okay. Now, second is about the complaint. Yeah, I talk about the complaint. When I talk about the complaint, am I going to describe the product also? When I talk about the complaint, am I going to describe the product? Yes? We have to describe the issues, you know? Like, am I going to say that I went to your shop and it was the festival season? Yes, there were discounts happening and I saw a red color double door Samsung refrigerator and I wanted to buy it. But when I bought it, this happened, right? But you can say, yes, that I bought a Samsung double door refrigerator, so much capacity from your showroom during the festival season, say in August 2021. This is enough. I am not describing the product. What is it about? I am describing the issues with the product. Okay. And of course, here the complaint, it has to be, right? Whatever it is, it can be mechanical complaint, right? It could be, yes. So something which is related with the appearance also, right? Something functional, whatever it is there that you have. What is our tone in writing letter to the editor? Is it threatening? I see you, right? Okay. Is it polite and formal? Please. Is it you're begging, please change my refrigerator? No? Right? So we have that. So what is it? I have to be polite. I have to be formal. Okay. Right. So my tone has to be polite and formal. Okay. You go with yeah. Of course, it has to be a requesting tone. It has to be there because now you have bought the product. We are actually at the receiving end. We are at the mercy of the manager now. Is he going to change it or not? Please change it. The heart of hearts will say, please, please, please. And then the surface, we are appearing very confident. But yeah, you have to show that confidence in your letter. Okay. So I talk about my complaint. I give a suggestion. Yes. So your suggestion, it can be a replacement, right? You are asking for a refund, which you might not get. Okay. Okay. So, right. So you're giving this suggestion here. Okay. Right, what is there? So it is a technical fault, it can be replaced, and yeah, you, how many days you are there, fine. And then comes this part. This is the ending of the letter. We call it the complimentary clause. I call it the close also. I call it the subscription also. We call it signing off also, okay? Right, so any of this here. So if I say, right. Yours obediently is an example of, is it example of salutation? Is it an example of a close? It's a close, right? It's a complimentary close, right? But if I say, if it's an example of a compliment, it's wrong. It's not a compliment. It has to be completed as complementary clause. So remember all these little things about it. One more thing can be asked. What about the way of writing the letter? Have I written one thing on the left, then I've written my content over here, and then I put my signing off over there? It is all on one side. Okay, earlier it was, we had a mixed format. Okay, so we had, yes, maybe that your senders or the heading on the right, and then we had the close on the left. Okay, so that traditional letter writing was there. But now, yes, so everything is now on the left. So we're not using blended formats, we're not using mixed formats, we're using these kinds of formats. So we don't see that, okay, I have space left over here, I can write my close over there. We don't do that. So you might have to turn to the next page to make sure that it continues, okay? Right? Do you think we need to follow word limit while writing these letters? Although there isn't any word limit, but we do not write endless formal letters. So we need to control yourself. So if I talk about 150, 180 words, it's more than enough? Yes, it is more than enough, okay? Right. So what are the things? So when I write a letter of complaint, I will not talk about the product, right? I will talk about the defect with the product. Yes. I will talk about the suggestions that I want to give. I want to talk about the replacement or the technical issues or whatever, isn't it? Right? Okay. Yes. So this is about your letter writing. So what all letters are we doing? So when I write, you have a letter to the editor also. The format is the same. Let me just discuss one thing about the letter to the editor. Now, when I write a letter to the editor, right? I have a larger audience. Yes, I have a larger audience. And when I write a letter to the editor, is it because, once again, I like to complain? That is why, right? I feel like writing a letter. Today is my letter writing day, so I write a letter to the editor. Is it? No. Then is it I want to highlight some issues? Yes. Who is going to take? Is the editor a magician? Does he have a wand and he does this thing and everything is sorted out? Why do we write letters to the editor if he's not going to sort out our problem? Why can't he write to the official in concern? Yes? Why do we write it to the editor then? How can the editor help us? Yes, he will highlight this issue in the public, right? Through his newspaper, it will be brought to the notice of many. If I write a letter, yes, that there are some pipes which have been in the park, you know, neighborhood park, they've been constantly leaking. And I've complained many times, nobody's listening. If I highlight this here, so when I write a letter of complaint, how many people do I write to? So when I write a letter to the editor, how many people would be aware? Many, isn't it? And of course, when an issue is highlighted at such a large number, many people would be aware. And yes, they would be, right? So when I write a letter to the editor is not going to find a solution. Then who all are expected to find a solution? The public is also expected, right? So of course, here once again, I would say when we talk about a solution, it has to be at the individual level. What are you going to do, right? If you see like taps open or pipes leaking in the garden, already we're talking about water issue. Yes, absolutely, Krishan, that is what I said. Very nice, good answer. Yes, absolutely correct you are. That, yes, the editor is going to highlight our issues in the public and it will reach the public. And yeah, and the first action would be taken. And here it is at the individual level. Yes, what are you going to do, right? We talk at the level of the society also. And of course, I will talk at the, so when these issues are there, you know, you take action at all different levels. Everyone here is responsible, then problems would be sorted out. Is a letter to the editor always a complaint. The roads are so bad, there's no water supply, people don't follow the rules, there are so many mosquitoes, what to do, life is such a problem. Is it always complaining? Can we praise people also? Wouldn't it be nice if we praise also? It would be nice, no? If we see that, see in this day, you know, like during such bad weather, we see the police, they're standing in the middle of the road, we want to be in the comfort of our air-conditioned rooms, but they are there. We complain because they stopped us at the red light. I wanted to jump the red light. Why did he stop? I was in such a hurry. I had to reach home. It was so hot. Right? But what about those people? They are standing in the heat. They're doing their duty. Have we ever appreciated them for doing their hard work? No. We complain. So let us take out time. We need to appreciate them also. Right? So letter to the editor is not always about highlighting issues that are disturbing to us. Let us be, you know, happy also. Let us be positive people also. Right? So instead of talking about such negativity, if you had to praise something, you want to talk about, you want to write a letter to the editor praising an issue, what would you like to talk about? What would you like to talk about? Hint, I'll give you a hint. Rishita has lowered his hand now. Rishit, yes, we can talk about the message which I showed you in yesterday's video. Yes, we can. When we talk about our sports women, yeah, so how wonderfully well they're doing. So we can encourage them. Let us appreciate the people who if, okay, you've lowered it. Okay, well, so you did some kind of a gesture, no? Some reaction was there. Okay, so we can appreciate them. All the institutions that were involved, everyone, and that first person who had that faith, who had that confidence that my daughter can participate, right? It's not necessary that my daughter has to become a banker or an engineer or a teacher or a manager. She can pursue whatever she wants to. Let us applaud that person first, right? So let us learn to appreciate instead of complaining. So if we have this medium, if we have it in the public platform, it can be used for appreciation as well. Of course, letter of complaint will always be letter of complaint, okay? Right? So yeah, you can't be, and you know, like, what a very dual in your approach. Yeah, although I like your services, but I have to complain also. Right? So we've said that when we are there, you know, like when we were doing our placing an order. Why we placed an order? Because we had faith in them. Now we have a complaint, right? So whether it was the defective supply, whether it was the late supply, and all that stuff. Okay, right? So yes, so we continue tomorrow with the subject verb agreement.